Center of gravity. But before we understand what center of gravity is, let's try to recall what we have studied regarding center of mass. When we talk about center of mass, friends, we have defined center of mass as, just give me a moment where I define center of mass for people. So we have defined center of mass as the point at which the whole mass of the body is supposed to be concentrated in order to study the motion of the body due to an external force in accordance with Newton's laws of motion. If you all remember, this was the discussion last time. That means you are going to consider a unique point whose motion would be exactly same as that of body. Now, why we are doing this? For the sake of simplification for analysis. All right. So here you can specifically mention, when we talk about center of mass, friends, we discussed that the motion of the center of mass will represent the motion of entire body. And obviously it has to be in accordance with, you can see, it has to be in accordance with Newton's laws of motion, friends. So this was regarding center of mass. Now I gave you the pretext, what we studied earlier. Now we have to understand what center of gravity is in a comparative mode, friends. Okay, so let's talk about center of gravity. All right, so how we define center of gravity, that is more important over here. So before we understand how we define center of gravity, let's say a body will comprise of, you can see, n number of particles. So if I'm talking about this body, you can see, it may have n number of particles. Now, every particle will have its weight. Now, where would the weight be directed always? It will be always directed downwards with the help of these arrows. You can see it's being represented. It will be always directed towards the center of Earth. All right. So, every particle will be attracted towards the center of Earth. Now, what we can do is, we will consider a single point. All right, friends, so you can see when I'm talking about center of gravity, there are n number of particles. So these particles would be exerting forces in the direction of acceleration due to gravity, that is, towards the center of Earth. So F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, they all are the forces acting towards the center of Earth, directed towards the center of Earth. Now, how we understand center of gravity then? Okay, so we would consider a single point where there would be a resultant of all these forces which is acting vertically downwards. What I mean to say is this F, capital F, would be representing all these forces, F1, F2, F3, F4. So the point through which this force acts vertically downwards, say that point is G in our diagram, that point will be considered as center of gravity. Now, how we define it technically, that's the second part which we want to see in the later stages. But prior to that, let's have an understanding how we define or how we understand center of gravity. So please make a note of this picture, friends, so that we move ahead in discussing center of gravity in greater details. So hopefully you can take screenshots, especially Rushikesh, you are attending the session for the first time. So please take the screenshots so that they serve as notes for you people. And then you can always, create your own notes out of it. Yeah, most of you say done in the chat section. So hopefully the screenshots are taken. So let's move ahead then, my dear friends. Okay. Yeah, good. So fine. So let's move ahead. So, in a way, what we have done, we have found a point through which the entire weight of the body will be acting vertically downwards. So, that's how we define center of gravity then in that case. So, just give me a moment where, I discuss सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी, डेफिनेशन ऑफ सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी, so let's define center of gravity. All right, so yeah, you can see when I'm talking about center of gravity, we consider, you know, the body made up of n number of particles, and then the weight would be acting vertically downwards. So there will be a single point G, you know, which would be considered as a point through which the entire weight will be acting vertically downwards. This point is called as center of gravity. So this is how you define center of gravity. Please make a note of this also. Once you are done with it, you let me know, and then we have a definition with us for center of gravity, just like the one for center of mass. Yeah, okay. Now, coming back to the point regarding center of gravity, here we have the definition. You can see the center of gravity is a point at which the total weight of the body acts vertically downwards for any position of the body, friends. Okay, that's important too. Okay. So center of mass was about, you know, the point through where the entire mass is located, and center of gravity is a point through which the entire weight of the body acts vertically downwards. That's the difference between center of mass and center of gravity. Okay, now there are specific cases. You can see if the shape of the body is symmetrical and the density is uniform, then you can consider that the center of gravity will lie at the point of symmetry, that is geometrical center. Okay, but then these two things are to be satisfied for that. The first one is, you know, the body should be symmetrical, and secondly, the density should be uniform. If the density varies, then not necessarily the center of gravity would lie at the geometrical center. The first point to be considered over here. Okay. Now, in such cases, you would observe that the center of mass and center of gravity, they coincide. All right. So, and see, for a triangular lamina, you can see center of gravity will be situated at its centroid, and center of gravity of the uniform ring is at center, basically. And same thing happens with the center of mass also. So, center of gravity and center of mass coincide. So maybe such body would move towards the stability concept, basically. Okay. So please make a note of this before I share a new screen with you people. And let me know once you're done with it. Okay. Fine. Yeah, good. Coming back to this picture, so far as center of gravity is concerned, you can see we proceed forward. Now, there is a line showing the direction of this resultant force. So here onwards, this is the line which is showing the direction of the resultant force, you can see. And such line, you know, and its continuation backwards as well as forward would be considered as line of action. So the technical terminology of line of action is being defined in this diagram. Okay, make a note of it. So here onwards, whenever I say line of action, that means the line of action can extend forward also and backward also, even if the force is acting at point G. Yeah. So once you are done with it, let me know. So we move ahead. Yeah. Okay. Fine. Now let's talk about center of gravity in greater details, friends. Here you can see. The center of gravity of a body, you can consider in the first diagram, may be falling outside the material of the body. So here is a shape of a body which has been shown to you, where you would find the center of gravity is falling outside the material of the body, and therefore the body is leaned towards that particular line of action, you can see. Okay, here you can see, in this case, if it's a rock, then center of gravity may be falling inside the material of the body. So both the things are possible, and both the diagrams are explaining you the possibility for both the cases. Okay, make a note of it and please let me know. Once you are done with it, we move ahead then. Yeah, people say done. Let's move ahead. So here you can see specific points where the center of gravity would be acting, you know, are being depicted and shown. So again, here you have a simple definition for center of gravity, friends. And it's defined as a point of application of a resultant force due to the Earth's attraction on it. It means the same thing what we have defined earlier. Another way of defining it, friends. Make a note of it. And let me know. So mostly people say done. Okay. Yeah. So let's move ahead with our analysis for center of gravity. Here you can see center of gravity of regular bodies obviously will lie at the geometrical center. Okay, so for a book, it will lie at a geometrical center of it. Now, if you just need to imagine, you know, if a scale is being tied and you break the scale into two parts, obviously this is the line of action through which the center of gravity acts, basically lies, basically the entire weight of the scale acts. So the moment you break the scale, you will find that the two parts of the scale, they try to get aligned towards line of action. Okay, that gives you an indication of, you know, where the center of gravity as well as where the line of action would lie, so far as center of gravity is concerned. Make a note of it. It's an important picture which will make things pretty clear for you, you know, so far as center of gravity is concerned. Okay, so mostly I believe you are done with it. So let me know once you are done with it. So we move ahead. Yeah. We need to understand how we work out center of gravity at times. Yeah, okay. Most of you say done. Good, cool. Okay. Yeah, good. So other way of understanding it is, you know, you just try to hold the scale at the center and you will find that the entire scale is being balanced on the other sides. Isn't it? You are just holding it at the center. What does that mean? It means you are just, you know, nullifying the center of gravity, basically, or nullifying the force acting at center of gravity. So here you can just apply an opposite force and the entire scale can be balanced, you can see. Okay, this is something which I wanted to tell you. You can just balance the entire wooden sheet, you know, on a finger like this. Now, why you are able to balance it? Because you are trying to manage a point, you know, through which the resultant weight of the particle acts. That means you are just putting your finger at the center of gravity and you can see the entire wooden plank is being balanced. Okay, so interesting point to be noted over here. So please make a note of this slide that we move ahead. It's the best way of understanding, you know, center of gravity. Okay, most of you say done. Good. Yeah, let's move ahead then. How to determine the center of gravity of a plain irregular lamina which is being shown in this diagram, you can see. So how to work it out? Okay, if it's an irregular lamina, had it been a regular thing, we said the center of gravity would lie at the geometrical center and so on. But what if the lamina is irregular? How to understand center of gravity in such cases, or how to determine center of gravity, how to locate center of gravity? These are some issues which we want to look into with the help of this plain lamina, friends. All right, so let's move ahead. What we do is we will try to, you know, place this lamina, we'll try to hold this lamina, suspend this lamina. You can see. So if you suspend it at point P, obviously what you can do is, suppose the lamina takes a position like this from point P, you just draw the line of action. So the line of action would be somewhat like this. So PP dash is giving you the line of action. When you are suspending the lamina at point P, now you can suspend the lamina at point Q also, you can see. When you suspend the lamina at point Q and you try to connect a plumb bob like this, so you will find the plumb bob would be in the direction of gravity or center of Earth. So just draw a line from Q along the direction of line of gravity, you can say, line of action of gravity. All right. Similarly, you can suspend the same lamina at point R. So again, at point R, you can, you know, draw the gravity line with the help of a plumb bob, you can see. All right. Now, all these lines, you can see, they intersect at a particular point. Now, the point where they intersect obviously has to be considered as center of gravity, friends. So you can see the point where it will intersect, we will consider it as center of gravity of an irregular lamina. So what I will do, I will show you the previous picture and this picture. Please make a note of it, and hopefully you have understood the experiment. Just give me the feedback in the chat section and take the notes also.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yeah, Gargi, tell me what doubt you have.
Sir, the points PQR, we can choose any points on
Any point, any point. Here I have specifically selected PQR. They can be STU also, anywhere on the lamina. But you have to follow the same procedure.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, okay. No problem. Hopefully everybody has understood this and you have taken a note of it. So please let me know, okay, so that I show you the next picture. Okay, most of you say yes. So please make a note of the next picture also, which, you know, completes the experiment then for us. Okay, let me know if you are done with it. Fine, good. Let's move ahead then. So here is a table for you people to depict where the center of gravity for given cases would lie. Okay. So if it's a scale or a wire or a sphere or a cube or a hollow cone, then where should the center of gravity lie? So these are certain specific cases which are being mentioned over here. So please make a note of it so that, you know, it helps you while solving the problems. Specifically, you can see for the first three cases, wire, scale and sphere, it lies at the geometrical centers. When it comes to cube, you can see it's lying at the centroid over here. Now when it comes to cone, it's one third from the base. Okay, that's where the centroid of the cone lies. All right. So, you know, if you're in a problem, if you come across a cone or a cube, then these things would help you. You know, they would serve as basics for you to solve the problems. So please make a note of it and then let me know. Well, good. Hopefully everybody knows it now, understands it.